Welcome back, everybody. Clint here with Classic Firearms, coming at y'all today with a manufacturer's review of Q, everybody's favorite brand that makes fun of everything else. Q. Why is Q so popular? Why are they so awesome? Maybe it's because they're so prevalent and supportive of their customer base. They're prevalent on social media and they just make cool freaking guns like the Honey Badger. And who names their guns after the Honey Badger? I'll tell you who. Only a company as freaking cool as Q. All right. So what is Q? Well, Kevin Brittingham started the company several years ago after he started Advanced Armament Corps because he was approached by certain individuals looking to replace the MP5. What he came up with was the Honey Badger. With the AAC Honey Badger, it was an integrally suppressed little, I don't want to call it a subgun, but PDW, chambered in 300 Blackout, or 300 Whisper, which is a very similar cartridge at the time. And the whole purpose behind it was being able to silence a firearm, silence a firearm that could replace the MP5 because they needed something that had a little bit better ballistics than what the 9mm was producing at the point in time in which they were asking for all of this. Enter Honey Badger, because that spicy little guy straight up doesn't care and just kicks a lot of butt. First off, 300 Blackout is a fantastic cartridge. I don't care what anybody says. It is not the same as 7.62x39, even though it is 7.62x35. Take a look at what the actual Honey Badger, or excuse me, the 300 Blackout is, and you'll see that it actually cycles reliably through AR platforms, where 7.62x39 has a reputation of not cycling as reliably through AR platforms. Not saying that it doesn't, but I'm just throwing it out there. The criticism exists. Just acknowledging that, okay? So, whenever you put something that already shoots pretty much a 5.56 cartridge, which the 300 Blackout does, if you compare a 300 Blackout cartridge to 5.56, they're very similar because you're taking the 5.56 case and stretching it a little bit. That's all you're doing to accept the 7.62 projectile. So you still take the same bolt carrier group as an AR or M4. You still take the same magazines. All you have to really replace is the barrel. And if you just want to switch out calibers completely, just have different upper receivers laying around you ready to rock and roll. This is actually a very innovative idea by Kevin at that point in time, and something that the military and law enforcement applications like a lot because of having to buy, instead of buying a whole brand new gun, change out the upper receiver. You can still use your same magazines, just make sure you don't get them confused because that would be an awkward day, but you save a lot of money there. That sounds like a win-win to a lot of people. You're getting better ballistics, better CQB, terminal ballistics and everything. And you're also getting better range because the 300 Blackout will definitely outperform a 9mm, especially out to several hundred yards when you think about it. So it all made sense, and being able to save money and using the same tools as before, super, super plus. So good job, Kevin, for starting AAC and giving us the Honey Badger. Since then, it has evolved just a little bit. We have given away several Honey Badgers because they are freaking awesome. The last one we gave away, actually, we gave away with a 60-round Surefire magazine because it fed it really well. 60 rounds of 300 Blackout through that little tiny guy was a heck of a lot of fun. I mean, just take a look at the footage that we've got here. The gun shoots. It shoots well, and it has a very unique recoil system in it. It feels good to shoot. It's lightweight, looks good. It does everything that it needs to be, and it cycles reliably. It's just a cool gun. That's all there is to it. So, very neat. Now, since then, they've made a little bit more affordable options as well. They have silencers that they offer, such as the Trash Panda and Thunder Chicken. The names alone are hilarious, yes. And they also make a more affordable option of the Honey Badger, the Sugar Weasel. So they offer all of these awesome products with these ridiculous names, and I love it. And like I said, they're good with the community. And recently they were actually attacked by the ATF because they looked at the Honey Badger and said, hey, even though it's running a pistol brace, it's manufactured as a pistol, it's a NFA item, it's a short-barreled rifle. Well, since then that has been a little bit squished, and we gave away a Honey Badger during that time, and we didn't get in trouble, and we gave it away as a pistol. And the winner of that firearm, as far as I know, hasn't been in trouble either. So, you know, hooray. Anyway, all gun laws are stupid. So, continuing on, the Q Corporation, Q Firearms Manufacturer, is still making innovative firearms, such as our current giveaway, like you see right here, the Fix. And what is it exactly that they are fixing? Well, in my mind, what they're fixing is, well, I don't know if they're fixing anything, but they are providing a solution to the gap between like your designated marksman rifles and maybe your recce rifles to your precision shooters. So instead of going from something like this guy, you down here, the LWRCI, you know, little recce that we have, to this guy, this precision shooter by FN, the Ballista, somewhere in between there, sure, it could just be an AR-15 with a variable optic, but maybe you want something with a little bit more accuracy and chambered in 6.5 Creedmoor, this guy, the Fix, and that's what fixes your solution. That's also chambered in 308 if that's the offering you want. 16-inch barrel on it, stainless steel barrel. It's going to be an accurate little shooter for you for, I don't know, long distance shooting and for a long time of shooting. I will say this though, even though it's a lightweight gun coming in at only 6.5 pounds unloaded without the ridiculously big optic and the beefy bipod that we have on it, the skeletonized stock does cut down weight and all, but there's not a lot of surface area right back here. Not a lot of cushion, not a lot of padding. So if you are doing some extended shooting with this guy, you might start to feel it on your shoulder some. You can either, you know, add a pad to it if you want, or just grow up, don't be a explicit and shoot the gun and enjoy it for what it is. Just go shoot the dang thing and quit complaining, okay? Your shoulder will recover over time. You know what won't recover? Losing out the experience on pulling the trigger on this guy. So how about that? Anyway, smooth action on this guy. A little stiff initially when loading and all that, but just shooting it, getting it out there, breaking it in, I think will help a little bit. Short throw safety on it. And again, something that I really like about this rifle is it kind of, I wouldn't take a bolt action into like, you know, the apocalypse with me. But whenever I first got my hands on this guy here, I was like, okay, you might make me change my mind about that, right? Just saying, it takes AR-10 magazines, which are super available still even in this market here. So if you've got hex mags laying around, you got Lancer mags, things like that, pop that boy in there and it'll work for you. Even your extended P mags, you can. It does come with one 10 round magazine. And also, because it doesn't have a chassis, you just have the receivers on this guy. There's no chassis, nothing to really take apart on this guy. That does cut down on weight. Like I said, it's under 6.5 pounds as it is, which is very nice if you ask me. Also too, you've got the full length Picatinny rail that spreads throughout the whole receiver of the gun and the rail, which I like a lot. So if you want to run any other type of, you know, optics or anything, you can. Cool. It is not an M-lock rail. You might see these cutouts that look similar. That's just all good for weight mitigation, but this is a preparatory mounting system. It does come with a Picatinny slot for you though that threads in to these little holes that you see going all down the rail. So we decided to mount one of the Picatinnies right up front here so that way we could throw on this AccuTac bipod. I am a huge fan of AccuTac because they are beefy bipods that aren't going to flex on you, they're not going to break, and they just work really well. They're easy to get into action. They take a little bit of practice, I will say that, because it's not a button that you push to deploy and get this guy redeployed, right? All it is pretty much taking the guy and pulling and then rotating it down, or even at a 45 degree if that's what you want it to be at, something like that. You might ask yourself, why would I want to be in this situation? Well, that's because it allows you to push into your object or whatever that it might be, dirt, anything else like that, allows you to push into the gun for a very, very stable shooting platform. And it's nice, put it that way. Also too, this little lever right down here allows you to free float this guy and swing it around. So if you're on uneven terrain, you can sit here and twist the gun for a good degree there. So very nice. thing looks good, right? So Q, like I said, have been around for a few years now, but they've actually been around, or Kevin at least, have been around a lot longer than that with the implementation of the Advanced Armament Core 300 Blackout Honey Badger. It's a cool gun, super popular gun. And like I said, Q just keeps making awesome products, and I'm happy to be offering the fix here. We still have some fixes on our website, of course. They might be out of stock now because they are popular guns. Are they cheap? Not by any means. That also doesn't just include the price, but it also includes the quality in this build. And Q backs their product. So if you have any issues whatsoever, hit them up. They'll take care of you. They're going to take care of their customers, because that's what keeps, well, that's what keeps us alive. It's what keeps other gun manufacturers alive. So if they don't have good customer service, well, they should probably sink. But Q does, so don't worry about it, all right? Anyway. After all that being said, they're an American company out of New Hampshire. Of course, everybody should know New Hampshire's motto up there, live free or die. That's what I'm talking about. Says it right back here on the bolt, live free or die. And of course, if you're already part of the Q family, live Q or die, am I right? Throwing it out there. All right, all that being said, you guys should know everything about this gun now. And the cherry bomb right up front here, that's your muzzle device. Also the QD attachment for their silencers, as I've already mentioned before, Trash Panda. So if you do get this guy, I think it would be a perfect suppressor hose, especially with that 16-inch barrel. Whenever you have the suppressor completely mounted up there, it's getting pretty close to the rail, and it looks like a good fluid connection. It looks really good on this guy. So. Maybe one day we'll get into NFA giveaways. Personally, I just want to have a couple of belt feds in here just to have on the wall and to take to the range, you know what I mean? So just go ahead and drop as many comments as possible about getting some full autos, because hopefully my marketing team and the owner here will read them and be like, hey, it sounds like the customers want full autos. Maybe we should give them what they want. Yeah, that's what Clint wants too, that's a saying, but they'll listen to you guys over listening to me, just saying. All right, I'm done talking about it. The fix, that is our current giveaway. Head on over to classicfirearms.com to get your entries in for this bolt gun. Is it just a bolt gun? No, it is so much more than that. It's the general purpose rifle everybody needs. It is the fix to the solution, or a fix to the problem you didn't know you had, all right? It's this guy. Also with the EOTech Voodoo 3.5 power to 18 power, it's a ridiculously powerful scope for this setup, and I love everything about it, so don't complain about it. It's free. It is free. No purchase necessary whatsoever. Again, many ways to gain entries. All it takes is one entry to win, but the more you have, the greater your chances to win. One of the entry methods is by utilizing a code word. Guess what that code word is? Fix, F-I-X. You guys can figure that out, right? I'm gonna leave it off there. Let me know your thoughts and opinions all about Q down in the comments section below. God bless you guys, and we'll see you next time at classicfirearms.com.